Hi everyone. In this video, I am going to explain how to draw frequency spectrum of AM using MATLAB. Amplitude modulation is the process in which amplitude of carrier signal is varied in accordance with the amplitude of message signal, keeping frequency and phase of carrier constant. First, let us generate the message signal and carrier signal, and then we go for generation of amplitude modulated signal. We calculate the frequency spectrum and display it. So these are the commands: clc clear all, close all, commands used for clearing the command window. Then take sampling frequency 8000, sampling time period equal to 1 by fs, let the number of samples be capital N, N equal to 1000. Now we set the time axis. Time axis is from 0 to nts minus ts in steps of ts. We also set the frequency axis for displaying the frequency spectrum. It is from minus fs by 2 to fs by 2 minus fs by n in steps of fs by n. Now let us generate the carrier and message signal. So we have to set the parameters for the carrier and message signal. The frequency of the carrier is 3000. Amplitude of the carrier is taken as 1. Message signal frequency is 20. Amplitude of the message signal is 0.6. Generate the carrier signal, C equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT. We also generate the message signal, M equal to AM cos 2 pi FMT. We can calculate the modulation index by using the formula mu equal to KA AM. KA is 1 by AC or mu equal to AM by AC. Here the value of AM is taken as 0.6 and AC is taken as 1. Mu equal to AM by AC, that is 0.6. Modulation index here we are getting it as 0.6. So we can set a different modulation index by changing the amplitude of the message signal. So here it is under modulation 0.6. So now let us calculate the amplitude modulated signal. It is given by the expression S equal to AC into 1 plus mu cos 2 pi FMT into cos of 2 pi FCT. So this is the time domain signal. S is the time domain signal. Then we want to draw the frequency domain signal. So in order to draw the frequency domain signal, compute the Fourier transform of this time domain AM signal. So we are using FFT command. It is a fast Fourier transform for computing a DFT of the given signal. So S is the time domain signal and capital X is the frequency domain signal. So FFT transform the time domain signal into a frequency domain signal. So here we are getting frequencies from 0 to right side, positive side, and we have to center the frequencies because the frequency spectrum should be from left side and right side. We are getting the spectrum shifted on both sides. So that is why we are making use of FFT shift function for centering the frequencies. So FFT shift of ABS of capital S, so we are taking the absolute value of the spectrum, because spectrum consisting of real values and imaginary values, we are taking the absolute value of it, and then we plot the AM signal. So subplot 2, 1, 1, 2 rows, 1 column, the first plot T, S. Now we are putting the title amplitude modulated signal. X label is time, Y label is amplitude. We also plot the frequency spectrum, subplot 2, 1, 2, 2 rows, 1 column, second plot. And we are using stem function to display the frequency spectrum, FO, S shift. Here S shift we are getting from this FFT shift function, and this we are displaying. This is the frequency spectrum we are displaying. Then title frequency spectrum of AM, X label is frequency, Y label is amplitude. Now let us run this code. And this is the time domain AM signal, amplitude versus time. Here the amplitude of the carrier is changing in accordance with the amplitude of the message signal. The message signal is available at the envelope of the modulated signal. By looking at the signal, are you able to tell what are the frequency components present in the signal? How much is the bandwidth occupied by the same wave? No, we cannot able to analyze it easily. That is why we are drawing the frequency spectrum of AM by making use of fast Fourier transform. So if you observe this frequency spectrum, this is the amplitude versus frequency. Here you are getting the carrier, FC is the carrier, 3000, and upper sideband FC plus FM, and the lower sideband FC minus FM. Similarly, for negative side also, we have minus FC plus FM, minus FC, minus FM. Now let us change the message signal amplitude here. Let me take the amplitude of the message signal as 1. Amplitude of the carrier is also 1, therefore modulation index is AM by AC, modulation index is 1, that means it is 100% modulation signal. So this is a critical modulation. So run this program. Observe here, it is just touching the zero axis, time axis. So we also get the frequencies, upper carrier, upper sideband, lower sideband. And we can also calculate the bandwidth of this AM wave. It is the range of frequencies occupying the upper sideband to the lower sideband. Upper sideband is FC plus FM and the lower sideband is FC minus FM. If you take the difference between them, you are getting 2 FM. So bandwidth of the AM signal is 2 times the highest frequency present in the given signal. So we can calculate the bandwidth also by using the frequency spectrum. So this is the critical modulated signal where the modulation index is equal to 1 or 100% modulation. So let us see the over modulated signal also. If the amplitude of the message signal is higher than the amplitude of the carrier, it is over modulated signal. Mu is greater than 1. So AM by AC, 2 by 1. So mu, when mu modulation index is greater than 1, we will be getting the over modulated signal. So let us see the over modulated signal here. Run this program. Yeah, this is the over modulated signal. Here negative side it is clipped off. So when you demodulate this signal, we are unable to recover the original message signal properly. So this over modulation results distortion. The signal is clipped off here when you demodulate it. So there should not be over modulation. Due to over modulation, there will be distortion. The signal will be clipped off and the signal cannot be recovered properly. So we have the same frequency spectrum here. Carrier frequency, that is FC. Upper sideband is FC plus FM. Lower sideband is FC minus FM. Similarly for negative frequencies also. I hope this video is useful to you. Now let us run this program by considering the parameters. Carrier frequency equal to 1000. And amplitude of the message signal is 0.6, carrier amplitude is 1, frequency of the message signal is 20 Hz. Here modulation index is AM by AC, that is 0.6, that is within the modulation limit. And we are making use of carrier frequency 1000 Hz. Let us run this program and see the results. So this is the amplitude modulated signal for carrier of frequency 1000. You can clearly see these frequencies, carrier cycles. Amplitude of the carrier signal is varying in accordance with the amplitude of the message signal. So we have envelope which is follow the shape of the message signal. And this is the frequency spectrum. We have carrier frequency plus upper side band is there, FC plus FM. And another lower sideband is there for FC minus FM. Similarly for the negative side also we have the spectrum. I hope this video is useful to you.